welcome back to History Adulan. I hope you all are enjoying the lessons that are uploaded on our channel History Adulan. The pandemic situation created outside is really a troublesome for all of us. Shortly, we all will be come back once the situations are normal outside. Today, let us start with a new lesson from 10th standard political science, judiciary. We know Indian government is divided into three organs, or there are three strong pillars of Indian government: the legislative, the executive, and the judiciary. The judiciary is most independent, autonomous, and separate from that of the legislative and executive. Why it is kept separate while making Indian constitution is very interesting to know, because it is being autonomous and independent and separate body. It is not functioning under the influence of any politicians from legislature or the executive. Since this is going to be a very interesting lesson, the Indian judiciary. First, let us understand what is the meaning of judiciary. Judiciary meaning to administer the laws or the justice. And these laws and justice must be equal for everyone. In fact, India have adopted single integrated court system in Indian Union and the states. Single integrated system meaning one or the connected laws for whole country. In fact, this court interprets and administers the laws made by the Union Parliament and the state government. We have already studied there are several subjects on which the union list, state list, and the concurrent list in which the laws are made. So, whatever the laws which are made under these subjects, they are been implemented and practiced under judiciary. Indian judiciary is divided into three tiers: the Supreme Court, the High Court, and the Session Court. Supreme Court is said to be the most important court in India, since it is also called an apex court or the Supreme Court. This court is situated at New Delhi, but not necessarily the functioning of Supreme Court must be conducted from New Delhi. If the Chief Justice of Supreme Court wish to have its functioning from other corner or the other part of India, then that can be done. Only he needs a permission or the order from the President of India. Second tier of the judiciary is called High Court. These High Courts are functioning at the state level. Now, some states may have independent High Courts, while there are some states which have a combined High Courts. For example, Maharashtra have independent High Courts, and there are many other states in India which are big in size, having more population, there are more number of cases, there are busy courts, so they have independent High Courts. While there are some states which are small in size, less population, and they have very less cases. So these states are not given independent High Courts. Example is Goa. Goa is having extension of Bombay High Court. Same time, there is a Chandigarh High Court which is sharing the jurisdiction of Haryana and Punjab. Then, if you think of a Guwahati, the northeastern state, some of the northeastern states having this court as a common court. Besides, the cases of Andaman and Nicobar Island, the people approach to the Kolkata High Court. So, this is what the situation of High Courts. And the third tier is Session Courts. This is functioning under the state judiciary or the High Courts. They are at the district level and the taluka level. So this is what the three-tier system of Indian judiciary. In fact, this lesson is going to be very interesting because you all are going to study something new related to law. And in this judiciary lesson, we will be studying about the Supreme Court, the High Court, Session Court, and definitely more about Goan judiciary, that is how the judicial system functions in Goa. Now let's understand in detail about the Supreme Court of India. Supreme Court As we discuss, it is said to be the most important court or the apex court of India. Same time, it is said to be the protector, custodian and interpreter of judiciary in India. The laws made by the court are full and final and binding on other courts of India, and all the high courts and the session courts that are functioning under the supervision and guidance of the Supreme Court. Composition and appointments. The Supreme Court of India consists of a Chief Justice and other 25 judges. It do not exceed 25 judges number. Now, if you think of the condition before 1985, then there were 7 judges and it was led by one Chief Justice. But after 1985, the composition changed and presently we are having a Chief Justice and 25 other judges. In fact, the Chief Justice of India and the other judges are appointed by the President of India. Sometimes, President of India also consult the Prime Minister and the Council of Minister in the Union. Sometimes, the post of judge may remain vacant or empty. This is due to the death, resignation, or his removal or the retirement. In this situation, the post should not be vacant. So the provision is made for this. This is called appointment of ad hoc judges. So ad hoc, that you must have understood from the word, it's mean temporary or for time being. So who is given this opportunity to be there on this post? One, either he can be taken from the judge of the High Court or the retired judges of Supreme Court and High Court, so that the functioning of the court must be smooth. After composition and appointments, let's move on to the qualifications of the judges of Supreme Court. To be the judge of Supreme Court, one must qualify the first qualification, that is, he or she must be citizen of India. Secondly, he must have an experience minimum of the 5 years as a judge of High Court or 10 years experience as an advocate of the High Court. Same time, President must think he should be a distinguished jurist. Distinguished means noted lawyer, respected and eminent lawyer. Tenure and removal of the judges of Supreme Court. Once the judge is appointed in the Supreme Court, can remain until he attains the age of 65. He can be removed on the grounds of proved misbehavior and incapacity. President of India can pass an order with the help of 2/3 majority in both the houses of the parliament. After the retirement, the judges of Supreme Court are prohibited from practicing in any court of law in India, but their services can be accepted for the government task. For example, they can also be appointed as a chairman of particular law commission. Remuneration. The salaries to the judges are paid on Consolidated Fund of India. Same time, they are also given additional allowances, privileges and house. Even Parliament cannot discuss the conduct of the judges except on the resolution of the removal.
Powers or jurisdiction of the Supreme Court. Supreme Court is armed with wider powers even to that of Supreme Court of USA. It has original jurisdiction, appellate jurisdiction and advisory jurisdiction. First, let's see original jurisdiction. Cases which can only be dealt by Supreme Court and not by other courts is called original jurisdiction. This solves the problems and disputes between center state and interstate. It empowers to decide any dispute arises out of election of president and vice president. Under this, we have writ jurisdiction. Writ means direction or order. This is a simple order issued on a piece of paper by the Supreme Court. Supreme Court is being the guardian of liberties and fundamental rights of Indian citizen. Parliament, state legislature, union state executive have no right to issue such orders. If they are issued, then it is unconstitutional and invalid. Supreme Court is given special power to enforce fundamental rights. Supreme Court have power to issue directions or writs such as habeas corpus, mandamus, prohibition, quorunto, and certiorari. Second is appellate jurisdiction. Supreme Court is the highest and final court of appeal. For example, a person got an imprisonment for 10 years. And if he appeal to the higher court, then verdict may be changed or remain same. Supreme Court have power to change the decision verdict of the lower court. So this is called appellate jurisdiction, in which a common person can appeal into higher court. This can be done through a appeal by special leave. Next, we have review of its own judgment. Supreme Court can review its own judgment, having a power to review, alter its previous decision and judgment. This is done when a review petition is filed, and this shows to the other courts of India that Supreme Court, being the highest court of record, they also can review its judgment. Judicial review. The power of the Supreme Court to examine constitutionality of laws is called judicial review. Like Supreme Court of USA, the Supreme Court of India too empowered to review laws passed by the legislature. Can declare them ultra vires or null and void or cancel or unconstitutional. Supreme Court is custodian of the Indian Constitution and highest forum of its interpretation. PIL or public interest litigation. This is individual can file appeal in High Court or Supreme Court in public interest. For example, there is a lot of garbage and chemicals are released into the river. Person as an individual can file appeal in the public interest in the Supreme Court or the High Court. Supreme Court is called Court of Record. The proceedings of Court of Record are preserved. They are conclusive evidences, and it has power to punish for contempt. Since this Supreme Court is called Court of Record, which is the highest court, it's also called guardian of fundamental rights. Supreme Court has a right to issue writs. This power makes Supreme Court protector and guarantor of fundamental rights. This can reject legislations, laws that violates fundamental rights guaranteed in the Constitution. Independence of judiciary under Indian Constitution. Judges should be free from all types of influences and control. They may be able to give judgment without fear and favor. An independent and impartial judiciary is essential to ensure rule of law, to protect the rights of the citizen, and for smooth working of democratic system. That's why Indian judiciary is said to be independent and autonomous, have no control of other institutes. Provisions of independence of judiciary can be summarized. 1. Judges of Supreme Court are appointed by the President. He shall fulfill prescribed qualifications, and President may consult Council of Minister headed by Prime Minister and Chief Justice of India. The Constitution assures security of office to judges. Once The judge is appointed, holds office till he attained age of 65, or can also be removed through a process of impeachment. His salary and allowances cannot be reduced during their tenure. The parliament can confer any additional power of Supreme Court, but cannot curtail its jurisdiction. Retired judges of Supreme Court are not permitted to practice before any court of law in India. Supreme Court has complete freedom to recruit its administrative staff. Next, we have is a state judiciary, in which the High Court is the highest court. Provision is made for every state or group of states and union territories to have a High Court. Each High Court shall consist one Chief Justice and other judges. Chief Justice of High Court is appointed by the President in consultation with Chief Justice of India and the Governor of respective state. While appointing other judges of High Court, President should consult Chief Justice of State High Court. Appointment, additional, acting and retired judges is the same process to that of Supreme Court. Qualification and tenure of judges. He must be citizen of India, hold judicial office for minimum 10 years or experience as an High Court advocate for 10 years. Age of retirement till he attained 62 years. Earlier it was 60. The process of removal is same to that of Chief Justice of Supreme Court. Even there are subordinate courts in the country. Besides High Court, there exist number of other judicial courts. They function under complete control of High Court. Two type of law courts in every district, that are civil court and criminal court. District court is the highest civil court in the district. Besides, revenue court solves the disputes related to land. Board of Revenue is apex of all revenue courts. Every revenue dispute first comes to the court of Tehsildar.
After having a detailed description about Indian judiciary, let's come and understand the judiciary in the state we all are living, judiciary in Goa. As per Goa Daman and Reorganization Act of 1987, Bombay High Court was extended to Goa. Goa, being a small state with less population and with less cases, we have no independent High Court, and that's why we are having extension of Bombay High Court. Goa High Court is functioning from Lyceum Building, Altino, Panaji. Panaji is not the only bench or the branch of Bombay High Court. There are three benches of Bombay High Court. One, Aurangabad, two, Nagpur, and three, Panaji. G.F. Kuto was the first permanent judge of Goa bench of Bombay High Court.
Subordinate judiciary in Goa. District and session court is the highest in a district. Below district, there are three additional district and session judges to handle civil and criminal cases. Each session court has an officer to defend the state called public prosecutor. At taluka level, judicial magistrate first class JMFC judge is called civil judge. There are five fast track courts and they are set in talukas of Tiswadi, Bardesh and Salset. One court of NDPS, that is Narcotic Drugs and Psychotropic Substances, at Mapsa to handle the cases under drugs, narcotics, psychotropic substances. Besides quasi-judicial nature courts like motor vehicle tribunals, industrial tribunals are operating in state of Goa.
With this, you all must have realized how judicial system is said to be most important and crucial pillar of Indian government. Judicial system imparts the justice, it administers the law and justice. Same time, it saves us from ourselves. It saves us from different type of discrimination, inequalities and injustice. Same time, judicial system increases the quality and functioning of a democratic system or the democratic government. That's why judiciary is kept above the legislative and executive, and since it is most important part of our democratic system. Hope you enjoyed today's session on judiciary. We are uploading lessons from 5th standard till 10th standard EVS, history and Konkani on this channel. So don't forget to hit like and comment, and also subscribe to get the regular notifications from our channel. Thank you very much and have a nice day ahead.